I'm Debbie Slocum, and today we're going to be working on nail trimming. We already have our dog. Our dog is already properly restrained and ready for nail trims. We have our neck loop. We have it attached to our groomer's helper. And we have our lap band, our belly strap, which is to support the dog's weight when we pick up the different feet so that it's comfortable for the dog to shift his weight from one leg to the other. Now we're going to go ahead and get started. We have our pliers type nail trimmer, and we have our rotary tool, and hopefully that's all we're going to need. I'm going to reach and take the first foot. I'm going to pull the hair back so that I can see the nail. And if you look close, you can see that there's a pink area. Then there's a white area. The pink area is the quick. The white area is beyond the quick. We're going to cut about 2 millimeters in front of the pink area. And then we're going to do the next one the same way. Let's get the next one up where I can see it. We want to be careful while we're holding the foot that we hold it in some kind of a natural position. We don't pull it way out to the side where it's uncomfortable for the dog. We're going to look, make sure, see if we have a dew claw. Some of them do and some of them don't. This one does, and it's quite overgrown. Okay. Now we're going to move on to the Dremel portion of this. Or the rotary tool. Now when we use a rotary tool, if we just lay into the nail, we're going to build up heat or friction, which is going to feel like touching a cigarette to the end of the nail or to the skin. It's going to hurt. So we don't want to do that. When we work with the Dremel, we're going to tap. And we're just going to keep tapping. So that we work around the edge of the nail. We're going to lay the front of the nail back further than the bottom because the quick is on the bottom. But we don't want to stay on the nail a lot. So make sure we get all the hair back out of the way so we don't get it wrapped up in the Dremel. And we're going to keep tapping the nail with the Dremel. It's actually wise to wear a face mask so you don't breathe the dust from the Dremel. Just going to kind of round the nail off. Feel the back side of it, and I feel that it's still sharp. So I'm going to barely touch the back side of it. Now it's smooth. No, don't try to bite me. Now we're going to do the next nail the same way. Just keep tapping. Move the hair out of the way for the next nail. Some people like to do this after the bath while the hair is wet. It can make it a little easier to keep the hair out of the Dremel. No. Move on to the next one. Now when it comes to the dew claw, which is next, I find that it's very difficult on a coated breed to do that with a Dremel. So I'm going to do it with a metal nail file, which is a diamond dead nail file. And I'm going to find that into the nail, and I'm just going to take it and file off any rough edges. Occasionally on a smooth, slick-haired dog, you can Dremel the dew claw. But I find with a coated braid, it's next to impossible to do without getting hair wrapped around it. And now if you want to zero in a little bit, you can see the quick in the end of the nail, that little center section right there. If you want to touch it with your fingernail, you'll actually find that it's much softer than this outer shell area of the nail. So if you want to see where you're right on the quick, you can actually touch it with your nail and see that you're on that quick. You want to go right to the quick, you don't want to stay very far back from it. You want to try not to get actually into it, but you want to go right to it, because once you go to the quick, it's going to recede a little bit so that you can cut it closer the next time that you do it. You do want the length of the nail. The dog is standing. The nail should not be touching the floor or the table. If a lot of times your quick is out far enough that your nail it's still going to touch the floor no matter how close, unless you cut into the quick. You don't want to cut into the quick. You just want to get it as close to the quick as you can. Ask your owner to bring the dog back about every 2 weeks. And if you do that, you're going to be able to, the quick will recede. You'll be able to cut a little closer the next time and a little closer the next time. And after about 4 trips, you're going to have the nail back where you want it to be. Hope you enjoyed the video. This is the way I do nails. Thank you.